Hello, in this video, I'm going to be talking about aromatase inhibitors. What are they? When might they be used? And what you can expect in terms of the side effects. Aromatase inhibitors block an enzyme called aromatase that converts what we think of as male sex hormones, androgens, into what we call female sex hormones, estrogens. By blocking that enzyme, these drugs shut off production of estrogen in parts of the body other than the ovaries. So there are two main sources of estrogen in people who have ovaries. There's ovaries that make estrogen, and there are what we call peripheral tissues, tissues on the side that are not ovarian tissues. So, for example, the adrenal glands, which are glands that sit on top of the kidneys, they're very small, pyramidal-shaped glands, they make estrogens. The fat in our body, including breast tissue, as well as other parts of the body. So even after the ovaries stop working, after they've shut down or been removed, our bodies still make estrogen. Men and women and non-binary people still make estrogen. And blocking that estrogen is helpful in people whose tumors are hormone receptor positive. So if you recall from our other videos, estrogen can promote the growth of breast cancer cells that have estrogen and or progesterone receptors on them. So they're sort of like food for cancers in your body that might be there even if you've had surgery and chemotherapy and radiation therapy, or even if you just had surgery. Sometimes cancer cells can escape the primary tumor in the breast and spread to other parts of the body. And what we want to do is decrease estrogen in your body so it can't stimulate those cells to grow. Aromatase inhibitors are a mainstay of breast cancer treatment. If your tumor has hormone receptors on it, hormone-specific treatment, hormonal treatment, actually has more benefit to you than chemotherapy. So if you've been through chemotherapy and you're wondering, why should I take hormonal therapy, it actually has a bigger positive impact on your outcome than chemotherapy. So who would get aromatase inhibitors? Not only does your tumor need to be hormone receptor positive, but you also need to have no functioning ovaries. Now that may be because of time, because your ovaries have stopped working over time. As we get older, our ovaries stop making estrogen. When we go through menopause, they don't make estrogen anymore. And that would be a time that somebody could have aromatase inhibitors. The other thing we do is we offer aromatase inhibitors to people who have had chemotherapy. We will offer ovarian suppression. So if you have functioning ovaries, we can actually temporarily or permanently shut down the ovaries. I recommend temporary to start with to see how you feel, and then you can be on an aromatase inhibitor, because remember, they don't work if you still have functioning ovaries. So we can use injections to shut down the ovaries temporarily. When the injections stop, the ovaries come back. Or if you're close to natural menopause, or if you have an increase in the risk of ovarian cancer, we might recommend having the ovaries removed. Or if you get really sick and tired of the shots, we can do it. But removal of the ovaries is permanent. So we don't recommend it lightly, and you don't have to have your ovaries out. If you're young and you're hoping to have children afterwards, you can keep the ovaries intact. We just put them to sleep for a little while. When do we use aromatase inhibitors? Well, aromatase inhibitors are good for reducing the risk of cancer recurring in the same breast if you've had low-risk breast cancer or high-risk breast cancer or ductal carcinoma in situ. It decreases the risk of the breast cancer coming back in the breast that had either invasive or non-invasive breast cancer. So even if there's little risk of the cancer coming back in other parts of your body, you may choose to take an aromatase inhibitor to decrease the risk of it coming back in the affected breast. If you have a higher risk of the cancer coming back in other parts of your body, and let's say you've had chemotherapy, or your tumor doesn't warrant chemotherapy, aromatase inhibitors are a great option. They have been shown to be slightly superior to tamoxifen, for which we have another video, in people who have no functioning ovaries in terms of decreasing the risk of recurrence and improving survival. The aromatase inhibitors have a little bit of a leg up on tamoxifen, if you will. We also use the aromatase inhibitors either on their own or in combination with other medications in people who have advanced or metastatic breast cancer. This is my first line go-to therapy in somebody who has hormone receptor positive cancer that's spread to other parts of the body. We recommend the aromatase inhibitors, often with another class of drug called a CDK inhibitor. You can see our video about CDK inhibitors, depending on how extensive the disease is in your body. So as you can see, the aromatase inhibitors serve a tremendous purpose in people who've had breast cancer. I would say they're one of the most serious advances in the last 20 years in the treatment of breast cancer, no matter the stage. All that being said, every medication has side effects. Even placebos have side effects. Did you know, just as an aside, 30% of people given a sugar pill will get nausea if they're told that they might. So I'm not saying your side effects aren't real. I'm just saying that even placebos cause side effects. The main side effects of the aromatase inhibitors, I am not going to cover all of them. I always miss some. I'm just going to give you the highlights here. You can drop a comment or a question below at any point, and you can go to yerbba.com to get your personalized report. I cannot cover all the side effects in a short video such as this one, but the ones I tell my patients about are short-term, and then there are a couple long-term side effects you need to know about. Short-term, the most common side effect we see are joint aches and pains. These are not in the bones. People can have bone discomfort, but what we see are joint pains. Those can be in the fingers, the wrist, the elbow, the shoulder, the knees, the ankles, the foot bones, pretty much anywhere you can get joint aches and pains. They generally start right after you start the medicine, and they will peak at 3 months. They may not get better. I have not found that, unlike tamoxifen, where side effects will get better after 3 months, aromatase inhibitors, if you get a lot of joint aches and pains, that's likely what you're getting. So if you're not tolerating the particular aromatase inhibitor you've been started on, there are three, you can switch to a different one. They are equally effective. So if you take nothing away from this video other than this, if you are on exemestane, anastrozole, or letrozole, and you are having side effects, ask your medical team to switch you to a different, equally effective aromatase inhibitor. And I would say many, many of my patients tolerate the second one better than the first. They're out of the gate. I can't tell you which one has fewer side effects. It's very individual. But that's the first thing we do, really, with any side effect. So joint aches and pains. The next most common side effect is vaginal dryness and other sexual side effects. These are very serious. We can have a decrease in libido because we're losing our estrogen, right? It's being shut off. The production of estrogen is being shut off. So everything from vaginal dryness to loss of libido to pain with penetration. And there are lots of ways to sort of deal with this. You don't have to lose your intimate life, but it's really important you know about the side effect. And a lot of physicians don't like talking about intimacy and sexual side effects. We're not trained to in medical school or in much of our training. So that's why we at Yerbba are trying to give you as much information as possible. Other side effects include everything from taste changes to dry eyes to some bone pain, which I mentioned earlier. Sort of anything you can think of happening when we go through the change or menopause will happen when we lower your estrogen. But we're actually lowering estrogen to even lower than postmenopausal levels. Now, I have to say, most people tolerate the aromatase inhibitors. The people who don't, though, truly, truly suffer. And that's why we have a whole video on how to manage side effects of aromatase inhibitors. If there's a specific side effect you would like to know about, don't forget to drop a comment or a question below. There are several long-term side effects that don't cause symptoms right away, but I want you to know about if you're exposed to these drugs for a long time. Generally, we recommend the aromatase inhibitors for 2.5 years if you're going to mix it up with tamoxifen, or 5 years. There's no benefit to being on it for more than 5 years. The aromatase inhibitors, by decreasing estrogen to levels below that when we go through menopause, are effects on bone health, so thinning of the bone, either osteopenia, which means light bones, or osteoporosis, which is more severe, which increases the risk of bone fracture. So unlike tamoxifen, and you can check out our tamoxifen video, which in postmenopausal women improves bone density, the aromatase inhibitors lower it. Now, it's important to know that when you are done with your course of aromatase inhibitors, your bone mineral density would come back up to where it would have been if you were not on aromatase inhibitors. So it won't come back up to where it was when you started treatment because you are now 5 years older. So if you imagine your bone density declining over time and you start your aromatase inhibitor, your bone density goes down as you're on it. When you stop the bone density, it will come back up to where it would have been with just time alone. It's not coming back up to where it was. We do have ways of managing bone health. There are both drug treatments and lifestyle things that you can do that I won't go into here. Check out our other video about bone health and also our video about managing side effects of aromatase inhibitors. The other long-term side effect is that compared with tamoxifen, you will see that people on aromatase inhibitors can have their cholesterol increase, and that can translate into a higher likelihood of having heart problems. Now, the risk of this is still quite low, but it is something that it's important to know about. You may see your cholesterol creeping up, and that is related to the blocking of production of estrogen in your body. That's exactly what it comes from. Tamoxifen, which we'll cover in another video, acts like estrogen and can strengthen the bones and reduce cholesterol. There are things you can do to treat your cholesterol. One thing I do really dislike is we put you on one medicine, and now you need to be on another medicine to treat that side effect. So there are some things you can do to improve your bone mineral density, like weight-bearing exercise, make sure you're getting vitamin D, and you know, lift weights, stay as active as you can. And in terms of cholesterol, of course, we know all the dietary changes you can make to improve your cholesterol. And if your cholesterol was already borderline, you may want to be on a lipid-lowering agent. I have covered a lot in this video, what aromatase inhibitors are, why we use them, who gets them, who doesn't get them, some short-term and long-term side effects, and I'm hoping it's been helpful to you. Make sure to subscribe to our channel if you like this video. It will help other people just like you find it. You can follow us on Instagram. Don't forget to go to Yerbba.com to get your personalized report. Thank you so much for watching.